السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to Quran Circle 5, where we listen to some of the verses of the Quran that talks about the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's nothing better and more beautiful and more accurate than to hear the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the creation of Allah. But what's the purpose of that? What's the reason for it? The purpose of it is to establish the clear evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. And the hearts needs to be filled with the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with getting to see the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. Looking at the ayat and the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases one's iman, gets the human being to reach one conclusion, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. If we look at humanity, people, they have so many different religions, so many different beliefs. And the common theme of all of these beliefs, all of them, except the deen of Islam, it's based on the shirk, associating partners with Allah, worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the roots and the seeds of this is when the hearts are attached to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the makhluq, the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is given divine attributes. When people get their hearts attached to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, turn away from seeing the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then of course the work of the shaytan that would lead people to worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether this, what is worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it's an image, whether it's a righteous person, whether it's a prophet of Allah, it doesn't matter. Every creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deficient, is weak, is in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what we're trying to listen to these verses, to contemplate, to reflect upon them, and to learn from these verses how to establish these evidences of the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before we start inshallah ta'ala with the recitation, I would like to introduce the reciters we have with us today inshallah ta'ala. We have Sheikh Karim Saudi from Egypt. Welcome to the program. And Sheikh Ahmed Muhammad from Nigeria. Welcome to the program.
Welcome.
Barakallahu feek. Sheikh Ahmed Rajab from Misr, from Egypt. Welcome to the program.
Welcome.
Sheikh Asad Al-Hawi from Egypt. Welcome to the program.
مرحبا.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all for being here. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this sincere for the sake of Allah. And for the viewers also, grab a mushaf, open it, read, listen, and try to benefit from the recitation inshallah ta'ala. We'll recite inshallah ta'ala in this episode, starting with Surah An-Naml. Surah An-Naml and verse number 60 and 61 with Sheikh Karim. Go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Amman khalaqa as-samawati wal-arda wa anzala lakum minas samai وأنزل لكم من السماء ماء فأنبتنا به حدائق ذات بهجة ما كان لكم أن تنبتوا شجرها أإله مع الله أإله مع الله أإله مع الله بل هم قوم يعدلون أمن جعل الأرض قرارا وجعل خلالها أنهارا أمن جعل الأرض قرارا وجعل خلالها أنهارا وجعل لها رواسي وجعل بين البحرين حاجزا أإله مع الله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses in Surah An-Naml, as you see, there's something unique about it, and it's more than one verse, that before the verse ends, it gives that question that it's by necessity, it brings out from every single human being that is truthful and honest, that they would give only one answer. The question is, أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ, is there anyone worthy of worship, any God to be worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The answer definitely, there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fact of the matter is that there are gods people worship, but they are false gods. They're not worthy of worship. So the meaning of أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ, is there anyone worthy of worship? That from these things that people worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the answer is not. But this comes after showing the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we heard. أَمَّنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, the one that created the heavens and the earth, and he brought down from the skies the rain, and he planted for you. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one that brought out the plants for you. And as a result of that, there are حدائق ذات بهجة, gardens that brings all kinds of ease and pleasant feeling when a person sees it, which people, they would benefit from it and they eat from it, and it pleases the eyes, and it's something for the benefit of the people sustaining their life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا كَانَ لَكُمْ أَن تُنْبِتُوا شَجَرَهُ, it is not for you whatsoever. You don't have the capacity and the ability to bring out these trees and these plants. The human beings, they put the seed in the ground, they water the plant, the seed is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the water is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the earth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The human being themselves belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them. All of this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then who is the one that sustains your lives? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth. So then it shows how evil and unjust and ignorance when people would worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then, أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ, is there any God worthy of worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? بَلْ هُمْ قَوْمٌ يَعْدِلُونَ, the reality of it is that there are people that they turn away from what is right, they turn away from the truth, they turn away from justice, they're committing injustice against their own selves when they worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the next verse, أَمَّنْ جَعَلَ الْأَرْضَ قَرَارًا, who's the one that made the earth a place of establishment that people can live on it? They're not flying in the air, they're not able to walk, for example. People, the human beings, are able to walk and dwell and build houses and work and do all kinds of things. This is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The human beings, they didn't do it. It's from the creator of the heavens and the earth, and he made in it the rivers and the mountains, and between the two seas, the sweet and the salty one, there's a barrier between them. Again, أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ. If these ayat, the universal ayats of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is what people see with their eyes, but it's not entering their hearts. The matter here should be in such a way that a person, when he looks into this creation of Allah, the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to take the lesson from it, to humble oneself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then a person would find the answer by necessity, by the way. It's not something that needs convincing, as some people think. The fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the heavens and the earth, this is a belief by necessity. We are born with it. This is in our innate. It's not something that a person gets with his intellect and he has to convince himself. When it comes to the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealing these many verses in the Quran and the message of the messengership of the messengers of Allah to tell the people, then building on what you have already inside of you by necessity, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sustainer, the creator, and so on, then worship him alone. بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, most of them, they do not know. And that's why ignorance is a disease. And the way to cure ignorance is with ilm, with knowledge. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the human beings the ability to learn. So why waste this mean to be among those who have knowledge? And the real knowledge is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ الْخَشْيَةِ, as Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah, he said, the ilm, the knowledge, is the fear of Allah. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ, that those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the people of knowledge. And that's why the knowledge that would benefit the person, the knowledge that would make the person put things in the right perspective. If someone, his information, and not to call it knowledge, would lead him to associate partners with Allah, to disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's an ignorant person. Even if he's the most knowledgeable in whatever sciences he's knowledgeable in, he's an ignorant one, because it did not lead him to the justice and to the reality of this life that would make him worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We continue inshallah ta'ala with the same set of verses and the powerful statements and the ayat of Allah and the universal signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that would bring the clear evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. And with Sheikh Ahmed Muhammad from Nigeria, would recite for us inshallah ta'ala verses 62 and 63. Go ahead inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء ويجعلكم خلفاء الأرض أإله مع الله أإله مع الله قليلا ما تذكرون أمن يهديكم في ظلمات البر والبحر ومن يرسل الرياح بشرا بين يدي رحمته أإله مع الله أإله مع الله أإله مع الله تعالى الله عما يشركون.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Again, the questions here and the very powerful statements and the evidence clearly mentioned in these verses, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us benefit and have our hearts benefiting from these verses. أَمَّا يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَى. Who is the one that respond to the dua, to the invocation of al-muttar? What is the meaning of al-muttar? The one that is distressed, the one that is in so much need. It's a state when a person is between life and death. Something that all other means on the face of earth, when it becomes exhausted, when it's taken, and there's no other mean that can benefit the person. Someone is drowning in the middle of the ocean and he's hanging to a log of wood, for example. He does not think of airplanes to come and save him. He does not think of a human being or a creation of Allah to save him. The necessity comes in his heart that he would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So who is the one that would save those who are in distress and in need when they turn to him alone and when they make dua? And the disbelievers, the people of Quraysh, they used to do that. And till now, people, they would still and continue to do the same. That whenever they are in the middle of some form of a disaster or in the middle of the ocean, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in the Quran, and there's a storm and so on, they would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. They forget about their idols. So these idols and these things that people worship besides Allah, they do that at times of ease and things of that nature. But once they're in times of extreme distress, they forget about these idols whatsoever and they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So who's the one that would respond to their invocation? Who's the one that would lift the harm away from them? And he would make them successors on the face of earth? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So even though there's a question here, the answer is not given because the answer is so obvious. And that's why the question comes in, أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ, because they are worshipping other than Allah. So how can they dare worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when all what is mentioned all belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And that's why it's something that is so evil and so unjust. قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Little do the people get the reminders and the proper effect of it in the hearts when the matter is very clear to them. The next verse, أَمَّا يَهْدِيكُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. Who's the one that guides you in the darknesses of the land and the darknesses of the sea? And who's the one, وَمَنْ يُرْسِلُ الرِّيَاحَ بُشْرًا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ رَحْمَتِ, the one that send the wind as glad tidings and it brings the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because it do all kinds of things and take the fertilizing the land and the plants and brings all kinds of benefits and the rain and so on and so forth. So the same thing, إِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ, these idols, these images, even prophets of Allah, they don't have any power to do any of this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one because He's the bestower of all good. أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ, is there anyone worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do they exist in reality? Because they exist in the lives of the people again. But is it real or just false? And that's why we have to be careful between, to make sure that we separate and differentiate between the false and the truth. Any human being can say anything, and they can say all kinds of false things. But false means it does not exist in the real way and form. So if someone claims that other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are to be worshipped, or they have benefit or harm or whatever, it's all words that has no basis to it, there's no reality to it. And that's why the matter has to be made in such a clear way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship, because other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they do not own anything. تعالى الله عما يشركون, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is exalted above all what they commit of shirk and associating partners with Allah. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forbearing. He is Al-Halim subhanahu wa ta'ala. He allowed this to happen for people to repent to Allah, for them to be given more time to see the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the universal ayat and the religious ayat, the Quran, so that they would return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If humanity know the value of the book of Allah, they would rush to read it and to reflect upon it, because it's to all mankind the miraculous words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continue inshallah ta'ala with the next two verses, verses number 64 and 66, with more of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sheikh Ahmed Rajab, go ahead inshallah.
أمن يبدأ الخلق ثم يعيده أمن يبدأ الخلق ثم يعيده ومن السماء والأرض أإله مع الله قل بل هم في شك من
MashaAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Continuing the same set of verses that talks about the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala compared to the idols that they worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that who's the one that initiate al-khalq? أَمَّنْ يَبْدَأُ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِيدُ. The one that initiated it without a previous example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us from nothing. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that would resurrect and bring this creation again physically into existence in the day of resurrection. وَمَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And who's the one that provides for you from the heavens and from the earth? And again, the questions gives an obvious answer, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The disbelievers, they believe in this. And this is again, as we said, it's inside each and every one of us. And whoever deny this, this is arrogance, this is stubbornness, but it's not the truth whatsoever. أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Is there anyone worthy of worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? In reality, is anyone that is being worshipped on the face of earth deserves to be worshipped? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one that deserves to be worshipped. قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Bring your evidences if you are truthful. And there's no evidence whatsoever. There's no revelation from Allah. There's no messenger of Allah would ever say that for people to worship Him besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. None of the messengers of Allah came with the message of shirk and associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the next verse, قُلْ لَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ الْغَيْبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. No one knows in the heavens and the earth the unseen except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nobody knows and nobody feels or have any idea when they will be resurrected. Even the angels, they do not know when is the day of resurrection. So the knowledge is the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permit for us to get to know some of the unseen by the revelation from Allah in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. And the disbelievers, their knowledge about the hereafter, they have no knowledge of it whatsoever. And we as human beings, we do not have knowledge of the hereafter unless we get to know that from the revelation from Allah, from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. They are in doubt of it and they are blind basically from seeing the hereafter and having the hearts attached to the hereafter, which is basically a call for each and every one of us that our actions should be, we do it on the face of earth, but seeking the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter. And also when a person stays away from the sin, have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had warned those who disobey Him that there's the hellfire is being prepared for them unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive, unless they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The effect of these verses in the hearts are amazing, but it needs to be, we have to revisit them. We have to purify our hearts by constantly reading the Quran and reflecting upon the meanings of the Quran. We still have more to listen to in this segment. And this time, inshallah ta'ala, verses 86 to 88. 86 to 88 from Surah An-Naml. And Sheikh Azhar Al-Hawi, please go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا جَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِيَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ أَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا جَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِيَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ وَالنَّهَارَ مُبْصِرًا إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يؤمنون ألم يروا أنا جعلنا الليل ليسكنوا ألم يروا أنا جعلنا الليل ليسكنوا فيه والنهار مبصرا إن في ويوم ينفخ أتوه داخرين وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses, as we heard, saying, don't they see? And again, this is something that is repeated throughout the Quran. And it's for the disbelievers, don't they see? And also for each and every Muslim, we should make sure that we see, that we look in the right way. We have our hearts and our eyes looking into the ayat of Allah to bring the iman and the faith into our heart, to strengthen it, to humble ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this should affect our acts of worship, our salah, our kindness to others, and so on. So, أَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا جَعَلْنَا لَيْلَ لِيَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ وَالنَّهَارَ مُبْصِرًا. Don't they see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the night for them, لِيَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ, for them to have this sukoon. Sukoon means not moving. Something that has this means of rest, comfort. And the daylight brings all kinds of energy and people are moving and so on. The subject of being calm and being in state of motion is something, these opposites are present on the face of earth in many things. Even what we need to do actually in our actions, that our hearts should have this tranquility and this calmness when it comes to being attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. That means the hearts are only relying on Allah, only fearing Allah, only worshipping Allah, not distracted, not moving too much in that sense. While our physical bodies, they move all over the place. That's why when the ulama, they define at-tawakkul, one of the definitions of at-tawakkul, as they say, sukunun bila tirab, wa tirabun bila sukun, which means that you have sukun, you have tranquility, calmness in the heart. And your heart or your body are moving, and it never ceases and never stops. And the same thing when it comes to the body is moving and then the hearts are in state of tranquility. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning this for people to see how the day and the night are different. And indeed, in this are ayat, signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the people that are believers. The believers are the ones that would benefit from this. Then the verses takes us to the hereafter and the day of judgment and the horrors of the day of judgment and an-nafkh fi s-sur. When the angel, there's an angel, there is his responsibility is to blow in the trumpet and everybody will be terrified in the heavens and the earth except those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. And the ulama, they mentioned this exception. Who are the ones that they would not receive this terrifying thing from blowing in the trumpet? Some said the righteous ones, the prophets of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best and everyone will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So everybody will die because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the ever-living one, that he never dies. And the creation of Allah, they all die, even the angel of death. Everybody will die. And then everyone in the second one, in the second blow in the trumpet, everybody will be resurrected. And one of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we see them on the face of earth as mighty and strong, which is the mountains, you would see them. وَتَرَى الْجِبَالَ تَحْسَبُهَا جَامِدَةً وَهِيَ تَمُرُّ مَرَّ السَّحَابِ. That you see the mountains, you feel or you see it as if it's there and it's stable, but it's moving like the clouds. How weak this mighty creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes and it compared to the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the creation of Allah. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected everything to serve its purpose. صُنْعَ اللَّهِ الَّذِي أَتْقَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected everything for what it's created for. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَفْعَلُونَ. He is well acquainted with what you do. So we need to be watchful of what we do, our actions. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the mountains and the one that would resurrect everyone, and all of these amazing creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He's the one that created us. He knows exactly our actions. He knows our intentions. And that's why we need to purify ourselves and to make our actions only sincere for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have more, inshallah ta'ala, with these verses and the great signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But after the break, so please stay with us, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Welcome back. And we're still with verses, beautiful verses of the Quran that talks about the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this time, inshallah ta'ala, we'll recite or listen to a verse or a couple of verses from Surah Al-Qasas, and then we go to Surah Al-Ankabut, some again of the verses that talks about the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a different set of status basically that we need to have in our hearts. Whenever we're listening to the Quran, we need to move our hearts according to the verses and according to the subject that is being mentioned. That's why there are so many different acts of worship that we observe and that what we do whenever we listen or recite the Quran. The fear of Allah, a person reciting a verse that talks about the hereafter, the hellfire, the fear of Allah should be present in the heart. Exalting the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever there's a ruling. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to do. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade us from doing. To have this ta'zeem and exalting the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hoping for the rewards from Allah whenever we listen to verses that talks about the Jannah and the like of this. And whenever we hear these verses that talks about the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth, it should bring the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts. It should make us again humble ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That this is the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we as human beings, we need to basically submit ourselves totally to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to be believers and to complete our Islam and our Iman, and to see the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll inshallah ta'ala start with verses number 71 to 73 from Surah Al-Qasas. 71 to 73 from Surah Al-Qasas. And Sheikh Kareem Saudi, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. قل أرأيتم إن جعل الله عليكم الليل سرمدا إلى يوم القيامة قل أرأيتم إن جعل الله عليكم الليل سرمدا إلى يوم القيامة من إله غير الله يأتيكم بضياء من إله غير الله يأتيكم بضياء أفلا تسمعون قل أرأيتم إن جعل الله عليكم النهار سرمدا إلى يوم القيامة من إله غير الله يأتيكم بليل تسكنون فيه أفلا تبصرون ومن رحمته جعل لكم الليل والنهار لتسكنوا فيه ولتبتغوا من فضله ومن رحمته جعل لكم الليل والنهار لتسكنوا فيه ولتبتغوا من فضله ولعلكم تشكرون.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses talks about also the signs of Allah, but it gives us a different perspective of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We take these favors of Allah for granted, and that shouldn't be the case for the believers. And that's why the verses is asking a question. Imagine that the things are different than the way it is and the way that we see it in our life. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامِ. Imagine that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the night continue to be and to stay in that state of darkness till the Day of Judgment. Who other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ. who is the one that you worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bring to you diya, light? No one. أَفَلَا تَسْمَعُونَ, don't you hear? And hearing is something that we need during the night. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the ability to listen, the ability to see. And during the night, when it's totally dark, people don't use necessarily their eyesight, but they use more their ears and their hearing, and it's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But again, the reality in this life that we live in, it's not all nights and it's not all days, but the verses is extracting something from us to reflect and to think, so that we really become appreciative of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the same thing a person can ask himself. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take the ability from me to breathe, you know, how much this ability to breathe is a great favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why the ulama, when they mention, one of them is Ibn Qudama rahimahullah, he said, in the meaning of which, that whoever think or become appreciative of the favors of Allah only when he loses it, he is someone that lost his mind. He does not have intellect. And most of the people are like this. They appreciate the favor of health when they lose the health. They appreciate the favor of wealth when they lose it. A believer should constantly be grateful to Allah. The fact, again, that we're breathing is a great favor from Allah. It's something that requires now for us to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fact that we have day and night and it keeps on changing, and it's not nights all the way and it's not days all the way, this is a great favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and something that fits our nature and our bodies and the acts of worship and so on and so forth, something that a person should be always grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to these changes. That's why the next verse talks about the same thing. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ النَّهَارَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. If it's all days, that means it requires movement and strength and energy and so on and so forth, and there's no time to rest. Who is the one other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that would bring night for you, تَسْكُنُونَ فِي, so that you can have that sukoon. That's why we need to observe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He created the night, it's the night is for the sukoon, for this calmness. But when people, they flip the matter, they make the night is the time for movement and actions and so on, then they sleep all day. Especially sometimes when people, they do that in Ramadan, for example. You know, the night is for the sleep and the day is for the action and seeking provisions from Allah. Except what is virtue during the night when everybody is asleep is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to make the night prayer, is to recite Quran. And that brings blessings in the night and in the day. And this is where the sukoon, this calmness in the heart, that a person would worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ, don't you see? And we need the eyesight more during the day than we need it during the night. And this is all from the mercy of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the night and the day. لِتَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ وَلِتَبْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. This is the way of Allah. And we should not change the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should keep the night as a place, as a time for rest. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam used to dislike speaking after Salatul Isha. He used to dislike to sleep after Maghrib so that he does not miss Salatul Isha. And he used to dislike to speak after Salatul Isha unless it's a guest or sitting with his family. There has to be a reason why a person is awake after Salatul Isha. Otherwise, a person should rest so that he's able to establish the worship of Allah, so that a person is able to get up at night and pray, so that the person is able to get up for Fajr Salah and pray. But when we see the life of us as Muslims nowadays, when the Fajr Salah is empty, the masajid, some of the masajid even do not have people in it whatsoever, because people are spending all the night in wasteful things. And even if it's permissible, it's better to sleep. So imagine someone spending the night in sins and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So by the mercy of Allah, to be grateful to Allah, to witness these signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continue inshallah ta'ala, and this time from Surah Al-Ankabut and verses number 19 and 20. And Sheikh Ahmad Muhammad, please go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أولم يروا كيف يبدئ الله الخلق ثم يعيده إن ذلك على الله يسير قل سيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف بدأ الخلق ثم الله ينشئ النشأة الآخرة إن الله على كل شيء قدير.
ما شاء الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى بيقول you again أولم يروا don't they see these believers and also for us to see we need to be able to have this benefit whenever we look into the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala initiated the creation how he created us what's the sources of our creation what are we created from and it's mentioned in the Quran from clay from mud to witness that to see this and we are created from one generation to the other from a dirty drop for the person for the human being to reflect upon this most of the human beings are not doing that and to reflect and to take a lesson that would affect our hearts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of all things and to humble ourselves so that we don't have the arrogance that would make the person away from seeing the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us and He subhanahu wa ta'ala the one that would resurrect us again. Inna ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ This is very easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The creation, the existence of this amazing and mighty creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created all things? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to recreate and resurrect and bring life to people after death and before that they had life, it's even much easier and there's no such a thing as difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The matter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kun fayakun be and it becomes. And this is the universal kalimat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The kalimat of Allah that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, man nazala manzilan, whoever comes to a place and he fears or so, if he says, a'udhu bi kalimati Allahi tammati min sharri ma khalaq, nothing would harm him. And seeking refuge in the kalimat of Allah, seeking refuge in the words of Allah. The words of Allah are the universal words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like kun fayakun, for example. This is universal words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the religious words of Allah, the Quran and the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is directing us that everything is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, just be busy with being a slave of Allah by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the next ayah, قُلْ سِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَانْظُرُوا that say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, سِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ walk in the land. Walk in the land to see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala initiated the creation. Something to encourage people to look into this and to see the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not to make them more turning away from the truth, but rather to humble themselves more and to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made it a promise that He would make people see the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the east and the west for them to get the lesson and for the evidence to be established against those who would continue and choose to turn away from the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, ثُمَّ اللَّهُ يُنْشِئُ النَّشْأَةَ الْآخِرَةَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that fashion the human beings and create them again for the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to do all things. Nothing is against the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He's the owner of all things and the most powerful subhanahu wa ta'ala. We continue inshallah ta'ala with more in Surah Al-Ankabut and this time from verses number 41 to 44. And Sheikh Ahmad Rajab, please go ahead and recite for us inshallah.
مثل الذين اتخذوا مثل الذين اتخذوا لبيت العنكبوت وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس
Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. And as we hear these verses in Surah Al-Ankabut, talks about the Ankabut, which is the spider, and the house of the spider web, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it as an example or a parable that is always going to be true with regards to those who worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the way of the amthal, or the parables that are mentioned in the Quran. It ties what is physical to something that is non-physical, to make the non-physical meanings very clear and very subtle in the hearts of those who recite the Quran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that the example of those who take other than Allah as awliya, supporters and helpers and so on, the like of them is the like the Ankabut, the spider, when it takes or makes its own house, and we see how weak it is. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ لَبَيْتُ الْعَنْكَبُوتِ. Indeed, the weakest of all houses are the house of the spider. Whether it's physically or non-physically weak, as people even discover these matters in the houses of the Ankabut, لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ, if they would know. That means, and the parable, this is what matters to us, that those who invoke other than Allah, those who seek help from other than Allah, and they take awliya and supporters and helpers other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are like the spider. Its house is so weak, so anything can blow it away. That means it's not something that would benefit them. So it goes against what their intentions are. Something, if people know, then they would never take other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as their support, as their supporters and helpers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take him as our wali, that means he's the one in charge of us. He's the one that supports us and helps us and so on and give us victory by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا يُنَالُ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا بِطَاعَتِهِ. If you want anything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what they are invoking besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the Almighty, the Most Wise. He led them by the might and power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody can overpower Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or do something against the will of Allah, and He's the Most Wise subhanahu wa ta'ala. But these parables, these examples, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sets it for the people, but the only ones that would benefit from it and make reason of it are the people of knowledge. وَمَا يَعْقِلُهَا إِلَّا الْعَالِمُونَ. If a person finds himself not able to understand this example, then he has to accuse his knowledge. That means there's a level of ignorance here. And to understand these parables and these examples, it makes the person make decisions in this life. That if we understand the example very well, therefore we have to act according to it. You don't make your house, especially when there's enemies, you don't make it as weak as the house of the spider. So the same thing when you have things and you're seeking support and help from others, they won't help you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one that would help you, because He's the owner of all things. We continue inshallah ta'ala, and this time with verses number 60 to 63, and with Sheikh Asad al-Hawi. Please go ahead and recite to us inshallah.
وكأين من دابة لا تحمل رزقها الله يرزقها وإياكم وهو السميع العليم وكأين من دابة لا تحمل رزقها الله يرزقها وإياكم وهو السميع العليم ولئن سألتهم من خلق السماوات والأرض وسخر الشمس والقمر والقمر ليقولن الله فأنى يؤفكون الله يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء
Subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for this recitation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about every walking creature, everything that walks on the face of earth, everything, whether it's human beings or animals or insects or anything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider for it. So this is another meanings and something that should be present in the hearts and the believers, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider. The creation of Allah do not provide for itself. They take the means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created in them. And the provider is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala provides for you too. So, and that's why the significance of wa iyyakum is mentioned. That means these insects and all these different creation of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not create the heavens and the earth for it. But He created the heavens and the earth for you, meaning the human beings, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So He provides for them. He won't provide for you. He's the provider of all things. Wa huwa as-sami'u al-alim, and He's the all-hearer. The all-knower subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the benefit of this? The hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, inna Allah awha ilay annahu lan tamuta nafsun hatta tastawfi rizqa. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to me that no nafs, no soul will die unless it's given its rizq, its provisions in full. So then as a result of that, fattaqu Allah wa ajmilu fi al-talab. Fear Allah, be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not make the provisions and the wealth and the health and all of these things make you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't indulge into the haram and the forbidden things. fear Allah, be obedient to Allah, because He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider. And take it easy on yourself, don't panic, don't be terrified. And whatever you seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you seek that from the obedience of Allah. And then the verses talks about the signs of Allah. If you ask them, if you ask the people of Quraysh, if you ask the disbelievers, who created the heavens and the earth, and the sun and the moon, and making the sun and the moon for your benefit, meaning the human beings, لا يقولون الله. They would say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَأَنَّ يُؤْفَكُونَ. That means why they are then forging lies and making lies against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and turning away from the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَقْدِرُ لَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that gives an abundance of provisions for the people, and He's the one that withholds it. Everything is by the wisdom of Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best who deserves to be given more and who deserves to be given less. And giving more, it's not a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with that person. The worst disbeliever on the face of earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give him more and more of this worldly materialistic things as a way to increase his sin. And also, if he's still alive, for him to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if someone is given less, it's not a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with him. So what is the criteria of what is good and what's pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If the person is upon the deen of Allah and obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to rely on Allah, and to, after taking the means, a person should have this rida and this pleasure and being pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the all-knower. And if you ask them, as the last verse as we heard, مَنْ نَزَّلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً, who's the one that brought from the skies the rain and give life to the earth after it's been dead and barren, لَا يَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ, they would say Allah. And this is something that is extracted from the disbelievers as a way in the debate for them to state basically the truth from their own mouths, because there's no any other answer except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the bestower of all things. قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, say Alhamdulillah. All praise is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the bestower of all things. بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ, most of them, they do not have reason, they don't use the reason. And this is the most basic characteristics of the human beings. And this is how the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for people to use reason, when they see it, when they see the power of Allah, when they see the creation of Allah and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it, the reason then requires for them to worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, to see that this life is temporary, and the hereafter everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for people to be obedient to Allah. There are many benefits, and again these signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, something should establish the matter of the tawheed in the hearts, the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to submit ourselves willingly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to put things in the right perspective, that this life is not the goal in itself, it's only a mean to achieve the goal, and that is to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to be protected from the hellfire. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all benefit from what we heard, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward the mashayikh, the reciters, for their recitation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for listening and for spending the time to reflect upon the meanings of the Quran. Our duty is to really act according to what we hear. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you all. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.